I get up, time is barely on our side. I don't wanna waste what's left. The storms we chase are leading us, and love is all we'll ever trust. Yeah, no, I don't wanna waste what's left. And on we'll go, through the wastelands, through the highways, till my shadow turns to sun rays. And on
YouTube. So as you all can see, I'm not on my bike, I'm in Gokarna. My bike is parked over there. So there are a lot of navvies and all for rent over here, and I had a little walk in the morning and I thought it's too crowded, why take my bike? And I was missing my navvy too. So left or right? And this is the guy who's in charge of the rentals thing. Follow kar raha hu aapko. So I just have to go to his office and fill up some forms. That is the procedure. It's a proper yellow number plate taxi registered bike, and I see a lot of them outside. Every yesterday night when I was coming here, I saw so many navvies everywhere, outside every cottage and everything, and I was like, areva kao, hello. And I was like, so many navvies. I'll put the link to his rental thing in the description below, and also the place where I'm staying. So this guy parks his bikes at this, maybe the both of them are friends, the owner of the Nimu guest house where I'm staying and this bike rental guy. So these are the streets of Gokarna. I'm staying near to the main Gokarna beach, and you'll see a lot of foreigners here. And Gokarna is not so famous as like Goa. And that's a good thing, because you'll find, you know, it's not as crowded, it's not as irritating as Goa gets sometimes, you know, too crowded, too mainstream, too idiotic sometimes too, you know. It's like, har kisi ko malum hai bhai Goa, mood utha ke chale aate. So I find this place to be very peaceful. I had a lot of fish in breakfast, I had fish meals. So I just hope the angle is correct. I just took the bike, and as you can see, it's by Wicked Ride. I didn't know that Wicked Ride is outsourcing this. Okay bhaiya, seedha hi na petrol pump ke liye? I didn't know Wicked Ride is outsourcing these things, like the rentals. So it's based off of a small kirana shop here, and we need to fill our own fuel as usual. The guy charged me like 400 bucks because it is holiday season, and also the rickshawalas here are not so happy with the idea of rented bike. Apparently they put scratches and all on the bike. So he gave me certain places where to park, you know, when I go to the beaches. And I was carrying my chest mount, head mount, everything as usual on every trip, but this trip I just packed it and I kept it in my room, and I forgot to put it in my bag. And I realized it now, you know, back in Hyderabad, all those mounts are chilling in my room. That's sad. So I don't think I'll be going snorkeling or anything. I don't know if they're there also here, but yeah, this is a very secluded and chilled out place. Like, you know, if you want to come with family or your friends or girlfriend or whatever, it's very peaceful. Not like Goa, all kich 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 kich. And people here are very sweet as well. So let's start off with the main Gokarna beach. So this is like the main market area. Foreigners everywhere, and the hippie culture is crazy here, so you'll see a lot of hippies too. Temples. Now a little bit about history lesson about Gokarna, which even I too heard from the locals here in the morning. So Gokarna literally means cow's ear, even translated, and it holds a very important religious significance, and it started off as a pilgrimage site and then it converted into secluded beaches, and you know, like a mini Goa. People here are very friendly, and it's not like the locals have a problem with the foreigners or the tourists. They're all living here in harmony. No one's cheating and no one, everyone's chilling. So on paper, weed, marijuana and all are banned, but I have seen like those OCBs, those paper rolls at every Kirana shop. I went to almost every Kirana shop. That's funny, that's where my hotel is located, and I think that's the route we'll be taking to get to Om Beach and all. And this is Gokarna Beach. Just find a sweet parking spot. People are getting into the water. I so feel like going into the water. So this is the first beach, the main Gokarna Beach. As you can see, foreigners don't really prefer this beach. It's mostly occupied by locals. Already liking this place. They're good waves. You can see a lot of boats and all in the distance. Maybe I'll get to Om Beach. That is the most happening beach here. And then you have to trek to the other beaches. That's what I read online, but I don't know how true that is. And I'll see if I can get a jet ski or anything from there. I see a jet ski here. Boring this beach is. Next we'll be going to Kudle Beach. Kudle, whatever. Chalwe. So again, we are taking this road. Now GPS, using GPS is useless here because the GPS is showing me round and round and round. It doesn't recognize these roads and the beach roads. You know, leaving the main Gokarna Beach, heading to Kudle, and I'll be using the old fashioned GPS, which is Gaonwalon se poocho. That is, you know, Gaonwala maps. Bade bhai, Kudle Beach kaisa jana?
Kudle Beach ko yahan se bike nahi jana padega, wahan se jana padega.
Acha, main road se jana padega kya? इधर से सिर्फ वॉकिंग करके जा. ओके ओके. इन फैक्ट आई विल जस्ट बी डन विद द व्लॉग, एंड ऑफ कोर्स मेरे को खुद को भी एंजॉय करना है. तो वंस आई एम डन विद द व्लॉग, आई विल कम पुट माय शिट हियर एंड गो वॉकिंग एवरीवेयर. सो मेनी हिप्पीज हियर. Almost feels like Goa. I haven't been to Goa till now, but yes. Having guessing that, you know. But everyone who goes there tells me it's too crowded now. It's just too. Everyone knows about Goa aajkal. Fish meals, yeah, the fish. If you are here in Gokarna, that is the thing you should be having. Fish and prawns. I had fish meals till the dog is chilling. Daggy! Sweet. Wants to commit suicide, I guess. So, you should. Fish and prawns are the thing you gotta eat. You know, that too at some local restaurant, not some posh restaurants. You know, that'll give you a good feel of the authentic Gokarna seafood. People are giving me weird looks on this bike. I don't know if that's because it's a navy or because it's a rented one. I hope I don't get into a fight with the rickshaw walas. बताया था हैदराबादी किसको बोलते हैं. लड़ा लड़ा के मारता हूँ बीच पे. फुल ऑन विलेज वाली फीलिंग आई एम गेटिंग. लोली एंड गोकर्णा इज एक्चुअली अ वेरी स्मॉल टाउन. यू नो, यू कैन जस्ट गो अराउंड बेयरफुट. एंड मेरा भी वही प्लान था, बट आई एम नॉट कैरिंग माई हेड माउंट. सो यू नो, आई डोंट वांट टू बी होल्डिंग माई कैमरा इन माई हैंड, एंड आई कांट वॉक अराउंड विद अ हेलमेट. पीपल विल बी लाइक, एम आई ट्रिपिंग ऑन सम ड्रग्स और समथिंग. So, you know, I thought, you know, and I saw the Navi and I was like, rent pe le linge, phir linge, kaam mein bhi aati. It's like, now I realize that I shouldn't have taken the bike on rent, but anyways. So, basically, all the beaches are very near to each other. You can walk and trek to every beach. But if you have to go by road, you have to go round and round and round. So, you know, 1 kilometer ka meko, 2 kilometer ka rasta meko, 8 kilometer pad raha gol phir ke jaane. It's both secluded jagah hai, and if you're planning to come here, please try to keep it classy. Chillar na ko kardo Goa kaisa. Also, most of the roads here are one way, so be careful. I'll get an idea of how good the navy is on hilly roads. Like, every beach here is behind a, you know, small hill or cliff. So we road pe ja rahe, so you don't feel it that much, but while walking you'll have to go. So what I'll do is, once I'm done showing you guys around all the beaches by road, I'm anyways planning to go out on the beach and I'll probably take a dip in the water and that time I'll just carry my M20 with one mount. So gunga to bhi tension nahi hai. But I'll get some footage of the trekking paths. Silky smooth roads here and re. Single lane but very smooth. That's why I was able to rip through the night also. Sweet road, man, sweet road. We are on an elevation, so I think we have to get down the hill to get to the beach. The descent will be starting. Hi. Sweet, these trees are obstructing the view, but just look at that. Look straight like a scene out of Far Cry or something. Just look at it. That was where we were, I think. That's the main Gokarna beach. Lovely. Ah, breathtakingly beautiful. I wonder how the sunset is gonna be here. Zurat padi to lock kar do, else I'll just be sitting, chilling, enjoying the moment with myself. But this place reminds me a lot of Far Cry. Ah. Turn right. Google Maps, are you drunk? Kahan jaau right mudke? Oh, there. Oh. No, not here. Fuck. I think I'll just have to park the bike somewhere and walk to all these places. Then what's the use of renting it out? That's why I don't trust GPS's. Half moon and small hell beaches. I'm going back to the hotel to put the bike and go out walking. Views as usual excellent. Bored of saying that again and again. I click some pictures also. Be careful if you fall here. There are no barricades, nothing. Idhar to bhi thode lage hue. Generally that's also not there. You know, if you crash you're screwed. Hello auntie. Salam. Hello.
Really, nigga?
Excuse me.
A few moments later.
Hello, cow. What's up? I think walking here is the best option. So I just spoke to a guy behind me. He said I have to go straight. There is a mandir and I have to go right from there is the straight road to Kudle Beach, which is very nearby. And Home Beach is another 3 kilometers walkable. So, yes, I'm gonna be walking a lot today. It's okay. Bear with me if I have the anti-shake stabilization and all that bullshit turned on. But still, thoda bahut shakeunga because I don't have a DJI Osmo or any of that. Just wanted the camera onto my little handle tripod thingy. So it's gonna be like a half an hour trek up the hill to a Ram Mandir and then I will be on Kudle Beach, like 20 minutes, half an hour. Pata nahi sunset kaun se beach pe milenga. And I was given directions by Russian. So, you know, Indian rahke, you know, coming here asking for directions from a Russian. Sweet. That's the view of the beach. The main Gokarna beach. Damn, I really want to go jet skiing and swimming, but as you all know, I'm here alone and I don't want to be taking that risk because I'll have to keep all my stuff on the shore and I can't really trust anyone with that. So this is a mandir, common shower area here. We just have to climb up these steps to get to Home Beach. Okay, I think I'll have to climb further more. Yep, it's a long way up. Ab malum hota cycling chhod ke bike pe aake kiti badi galti kare. I think these are... Excuse me, Home Beach is this way, right?
Home Beach.
Kudle Beach. Beach.
This way and that way.
Thank you. I need to start jogging. Anyways, so this is the view from the half flight of steps. It's gonna take me to the mandir and from the mandir to Kudle beach I'll hopefully grab a bite of something. And my phone is ringing. So in the middle of nowhere you're greeted with this board which says halfway house, veg, thali, fruit juice, breakfast, all homemade food. Seems legit, and that is the entry. Damn, I don't remember the last time I walked so much. Where the fuck is the beach? So stairs again. And I see a lot of Russian families also coming here. And I hate stairs because I have to go down and then climb back up. So that is the path behind. And you see a lot of Russian families here. I told you they're walking. Nice. The last few meters were like this. And we're finally at Kudle Beach. I see a lot of foreigners here. It's a more of a secluded beach. And as the board here reads, deaths in Kudle Beach sea water is danger for swimming. It's not danger, it's dangerous for swimming. I don't know, there's so many families, like Russian families, Russian because I know I can understand Russian when I hear it. I mean, seeing it in video games. Apart from that, I think a lot of Israelis are here too. And I'm not much of a walker, if you guys have figured out by now. So don't mind if I look too tired. I'm still thinking how I'm gonna go back. And I've just covered like this beach, there's Om and there's two other beaches. So I love the view here already. So as you can see, beautiful beach, calm waves. Not many people around. Mostly it's foreigners. It's pretty neat and clean here. I don't see many restaurants as well. I need to grab some fish and prawns. I can't get enough of this view. It's beautiful. It's beautiful. So you see a lot of foreigners on this beach. I've said that like 100 times. But there are also families, kids. They're all chilling. Some are sleeping. Some are smoking. We chilled out, some are jogging. And it's like no one bothers the other person. Even cops were rounding the place, but no one seemed to care that much. There's some people selling some stuff as well. I don't know what they're selling, but crazy people. Chocolate balls. And then there are people playing tennis. This is one beach. There's Om Beach and a lot of other beaches. I don't know if I'm gonna cover those today. I feel too tired already. And I think I should save that for the other time. Some people are playing beach volleyball as well. Sweet. I think I'll just enjoy the sunset from here. So I'm just sitting on the beach, pairing the camera with everything. I really wish I'd come here with somebody who could look after my luggage. And this place is beautiful. There are people swimming and taking pictures inside. A lot of this hippie crowd chilling out here. Beautiful board here. Of course, beautiful angrezes, goes without saying. I'm not shooting much of it because chillar dikhta and it's not good to shoot somebody without their permission when they're roaming around half naked. But nevertheless, I took a lot of pictures. So I just ordered a Coke and some prawns sitting at this cafe here. You see, that's the view outside. Let's just go outside and show it to you. This is the view from the cafe. And yes, they do accept credit and debit cards. The name of this place is not sure, it's not written. Cafe Paradise, that's the name of this place.
Eventually.
So as you can see, the sun is setting. It's a beautiful sunset scene. And unfortunately, I have no energy left to go to Om Beach or any other beach for that fact. And also I want to leave it for the next trip, which I'm planning soon. I'm very exhausted with all the riding I've done since the past 1 week. And also I walked quite a lot today. Rode on very bad roads. So I guess this is gonna be it for the short and simple Gokarna vlog. Next time I come here, I'm gonna dedicate one single trip to Goa and Gokarna, so I can show you guys more of it in peace. There is lots of things I couldn't do. So there's like a hippie market here.
Oh, and yeah, we are going to check it out.
And I met somebody from Bangalore.
Bengaluru.
So now I have company. Thankfully, I'm not alone. So as you can see behind me,
okay,
the market is peace.
The market is right there.
So let's go ahead, check out what all do they have.
Hey bro, Halkogar.
Where?
Yeah bro, I should have.
It's amazing. Yeah, right. There are people playing the tabla. For starters, there is a... For starters, there is a ship, a boat, not a ship, which will take you through all the beaches and all. I wanted to do that, but the sun is setting and I have to ride back home tomorrow, so no. And there are cliffs, so that is also... I couldn't do that. Om Beach, the most happening beach, I couldn't go there also because I'm completely drained and tired. So I guess I'll catch up with you guys again. Thank you for watching.